up with Guerrillacomm. Looking forward to it, to compare and contrast systems and capabilities in a in this fall trip, although temperatures will be at or below freezing.
What's up, brother?
What's up? Nice to meet you, man. Sorry, let me stash the keys. So you all ready?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Cool. I think when we get to the top, whenever we get to camp, we ought to do like a gear layout, like next to each other and see, because I really don't have that much
right
in there. It's the food. It's the food, man.
I
was thinking about that. I was like, he cannot be getting very much sleep at all, because that wind was just,
I hope it didn't mess you up.
No, because my tent was flapping just as much, but it wasn't like touching me.
Right. Oh, it didn't touch me either. Like my head part.
Uh huh.
It was off my face, so.
Oh, okay.
The only thing that was a downer was, you see how everything is all loose? The flapping of the material, it was like an alarm clock every so often when a gust of wind comes around. And it came around every minute or so. So I didn't get much sleep last night, but it wasn't due to comfort. It was just due to the noise. With my layering system, here I got some thermal pants, my regular pants underneath. A down jacket and whatnot, and the stuff I got inside, I stayed pretty toasty. I was pretty much borderline sweating, and it got down to around 32 degrees last night, so freezing, and I was toasty inside, despite the noise.
Did you get out for a while and like try and tweak your shit?
No, not
at all.
I
saw a headlamp. On.
Oh, in the middle of the night, I was trying to recharge my GPS batteries.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's what I was doing.
Well, I was like, is that the moon? I'm like, I'm missing it. I'm missing the time lapse of the moon. I gotta get this. You just don't get this kind of color. I mean, that's blue. Okay, just wanted to give you an idea of what these blustery winds did. Everything is inundated in dirt and grass blowing in from outside, which is the reason why, you know, I don't particularly care for tarp camping. Alright, because it's just the grime is everywhere. That's everywhere. It's all over the sleeping bag. And I've been blowing stuff off, but it's it's just not a not a healthy way to live. And remember, we are we do these things to practice bug out stuff. So, we're not out here just camping for the heck of it. Well, yeah, we are, but I mean, it's more about using our systems, seeing what they can handle and what needs to be improved on. That's pretty much the reason why we do these things. But yeah, here's a MSR water filter, and it's like just, it's filthy. The whole place is just nasty because of nature. So, you know, what does your system afford field sanitation, you know, and staying as clean as possible? Because dirt just makes things suck, you know, just way much more. All right, so I'm going to have to filter some water first before I get to boiling. And do me up some breakfast. I'm going to have some leftovers from last night, which we got up here, we were starving, and then when we ate, once we finally cooked, it was like too much. I couldn't finish it, but gonna enjoy the rest of it today. We're getting close to the top of Chicken Spring Lake. We're camped down there. My big Agnes looks like a rock down there. We're about to see this killer view. Okay, so what you're looking at here is Big Whitney Meadow. That's what that big area is down in the low ground. And then farther to the west, in that barren rocky spot over there, that's the boreal plateau. Probably about 8 kilometers map distance. Definitely not walking distance. But yeah. Whew. Yeah. So we found a trail on the crest here. I don't know how high it goes. But we're still, do you have your altimeter on you?
No, I don't.
I know it was I know we're above 11,000 at camp, so we'll be up there. Yep. That's gonna be killer. But we're gonna see if we can get up there and maybe see Mount Whitney on the other side. That'd be pretty exciting. So we found ourselves on the top of the ridge here, which would happen to be the Pacific Crest Trail, which was leading to a place we didn't want to go. Is that doable?
The other side.
Okay, this way? All right. And that isn't where we wanted to go. We wanted to find our way up to the top of that. But the PCT, and I apologize for the wind, I hope you can hear me, but the PCT would have taken us along the top of the tree line here and around, and it just would have kept us in the low ground, and we would have had to walk 3 kilometers before we would have been able to get around that sucker to see north. The trail was meandering northwest. So you're saying we got to come back down and around?
Yeah.
That's too wide to span right there?
We span it.
Okay. But what's on the other side? Is it fucked up?
There's a dump of rocks in the hit up.
I don't know if my little ass can.
Yeah.
again, kudos to the Solomons for having that sticky grip. Yeah, I think we're going to be done once we get to the, just through this saddle right here. So what we would want to do, ideally, would be to start going through that big-ass boulder field and stay on the ridge line to get up to the top there. But that shit ain't happening, bro.
It's so freaking cold.
Yeah, that too. That too.
It's...
it's something, it's just too cold and blustery right now, man. And then, I can't even imagine, I mean, the trees don't look like they're, well, I guess the treetops are moving up there, but I can't even imagine the wind up top there.
Yeah, the
knife
edge up there?
Yep.
Shit, we're getting quite a few big gusts down there.
Yeah. Yeah. But, say again?
Like a little clearing over here.
Carefully, yep. Technical. It's technical shit. You gotta put your balance on each rock before, or try it out, test your weight on it before you give it your all. Yeah, we can take this down, right back down to the PCT, and it's probably right there. Probably just came up the trail. Yeah, but it was cool. It was fun, man. Guys, this is the reality right here, man. This is the reality. We got 20 mile an hour sustained winds, and it's ice cold inside the tent. Inside the tent, it's a balmy 62 degrees. All right, but outside, the wind is just swirling. Me and Guerrillacomm are trying to talk about stuff which would never pass the microphones. The microphones would be blasted out by the wind. So, best bet is just get inside, receive some of this awesome sunlight which is reflecting off of my tent here, and just warm up, man. Time to take a nap. Grab some cashews, not necessarily in that order, and just chill. This is the reality of the wilderness. I don't know where people are going in their videos when they're, you know, and I'm just covered with debris from the wind. But that's the true test of your kit. You can't expect to use your stuff and have it work right in every condition. So try and get out there in different types of conditions and test your kit in those environments. This is the second time I'm in the Big Agnes not Fly Creek, but I'm in the Big Agnes tent that I've used before, but I'm without the tent. I'm just doing the fast fly setup, and I've done this before, but I've got debris just flying in here everywhere. Right, it's over everything, and that's part of the problem with tarp camping. Now, the conditions that we're in, almost winter, late fall, there's no bugs, there's no creepy crawlies on the ground here. We're in this pristine setting, beautiful setting, but still, it's not conditional for tarp camping. Guerrillacomm used a tarp last night. He brought a hammock setup, but he used it in a ground configuration, and it was, you know, he managed through the night, but it was not a great experience for him. Me, I have this giant canopy, in effect tarp camping, but it's just the fly, you know, of the Big Agnes tent. Copper spur, Big Agnes copper spur, UL1. So you take the tent away, and now it's just huge, cavernous. I got all my gear here and everything. You got lots of room to stretch out, you know, for one person. But in this breeze, this constant 20 mile per hour buffeting of the kit, and the environment outside around you, you know, you're forced to deal with reality. And the reality is, get out of the cold, you know, and just relax. Tomorrow is another day. Tomorrow we descend. So it's going to be about the knees and the hamstrings tomorrow. It'll still be challenging going down that pass. But hopefully I've eaten enough of my food weight to lighten my load substantially. So it's just drink water, stay warm. That's all it is for the rest of the day. I'm going to try and get some cool time-lapse stuff tonight and in the morning. And then we'll be heading down the hill. So, that's it, man. I'm just going to chill and relax. Oh, and just stay warm. That is it. Drink water and stay warm. Has gotten nipply out there. Man, just got finished with dinner with Guerrillacomm. I wish you guys could have been there. I wish we could have captured the conversations, which is why I wanted to do this trip, but it's just too windy. It's too windy. It's too cold. It just would not have been captured out there with the wind gusts, and it's still going. As a matter of fact, last time I got with you guys, it was like 62 degrees. Now, as we look at the temperature here, you can see, hopefully you can see this, that it's like down to 36. It's 36.6 degrees and dropping. So it is going to be a cold one. It's already colder than it was this morning, like at 3 when I first woke up this morning, about 3 o'clock. It was about 37. Not freezing, but pretty cool. But no wind. Now it's pretty, it's windy with the cold, so it's going to be pretty dramatic tonight. Great trip. I just wish like we could have captured more of those conversations that GC and I had. Now the only thing that's really left is to snivel up and get ready for the morning for the hump down the hill. I'm gonna try and get, see, the breeze is pretty intense, and it's just blowing debris in here, man. I tried to stack up all my stuff in the, but again, just another reason why I don't like to tarp camp. You're too susceptible to the environment in a tarp. Let me snivel up and get ready for tomorrow. See you guys in the morning.